is the pay. All the agencies have been reporting to us for years about how they're losing talent to the private sector, where folks can earn a whole lot more for doing the same work. Wait times at the DMV are in large part due to vacant staff positions. State agencies are struggling to serve the public. We're losing teachers at a rate of 11.5% on average this year. It's even higher for new teachers, which is more, and we're losing teachers at a rate that we haven't seen before. Too many vacant positions, and that number is even higher than it was the year before. So what do employers do when they cannot fill positions? They raise the pay, and that's what we need to do. That's the obvious and overdue remedy here that we need, and that's why I'm sending forth an amendment.
Send forward your amendment. Clerk will read.
Senator Marcus moves to amend the bill.
Senator Marcus is recognized to explain Amendment 2.
Thank you, Mr. President. This amendment simply addresses the real core problem that we have in filling vacancies at state agencies, which is to raise the pay for all state employees. That includes teachers, school personnel, state highway patrol, law enforcement officers, community colleges, judicial branch employees, all the places where we have massive vacancies. It also includes a one-time bonus for state employees, additional funds for retention and recruitment as requested in the governor's budget. We can afford to do this. We have a budget surplus. It's an urgent need. It's the right thing to do to invest in our state and our people, and I hope you'll support this amendment.
Discussion or debate? Senator Hise, what purpose your eyes?
Move that Amendment 2 do lie upon the table.
Second.
Been moved and seconded that Amendment 2 do lie upon the table. It's a non-debatable motion. We'll go immediately to a vote. Question for the Senate, is the motion to table Amendment 2? All in favor of the motion would vote aye. All opposed, vote no. 5 seconds be allowed for the voting clerk. Record the vote. Senator Sawry, aye. Senator Proctor, aye. 28, having voted in the affirmative, 12 in the negative, the motion does carry, and Amendment 2 is tabled, and the bill is back before us. Discussion or debate on House Bill 223 on its second reading? Hearing none. Question for the Senate, is the passage of House Bill 223 on its second reading? All in favor will vote aye. All opposed, vote no. 5 seconds be allowed for the voting clerk. Record the vote. Senator Smith? Aye or no? Senator Sawry, aye. 40 having voted in the affirmative, none in the negative. House Bill 223 has passed its second reading and will, without objection, be read a third time.
The General Assembly of North Carolina enacts.
Discussion or debate on third reading? Hearing none. Question for the Senate, is the passage on third reading of House Bill 223. All in favor will say aye. All opposed, no. The ayes have it, and House Bill 223 has passed its third reading. The amendment will be engrossed, and the bill will be returned to the House.
Very, very interesting. So you heard Senator Ralph Hise, who covers Mitchell County as well as several other Western North Carolina counties, lie upon the table, basically kills the bill, kills the amendment to the bill. And so he, in essence, made the motion to stop all of those possible salary increases for state troopers, teachers, and others that you saw in that amendment. Thanks for watching today at the NCGA. Again, I'm Annie Dance. See you next time.